So after the launch of the Google Pixel 3 and 3 XL, there were rumors throughout 2018 that Google was secretly working on a mid-range budget version of a Google Pixel phone. And a lot of us really were wondering what would the experience be like if Google released a budget option. Come May 7th, 2019, that rumor turned into reality with the release of the Pixel 3a, which then everyone at Google I/O ended up getting to hold the phone in hand and even walk away with them. But it still left a lot of people wondering, like, how was the experience going to be? Well, when you think about the specs of this device, the Snapdragon 670, 64 gigs of onboard storage with 4 gigabytes of RAM, a base model size Pixel 3a and a 3a XL with the same cameras as the 3. So you have the Sony IMX363, 12.2 megapixel at an f1.8 aperture, single lens shooter in the back, and selfie cam in the front. 3000 milliamp hour battery, no water resistance, no wireless charging, it's polycarbonate built. So you don't have to worry about glass. Like, these things people were kind of focused on. And it amazed us that even though I had a Snapdragon 670, it's smooth, it flies, it's like butter. Crazy, right? But I've had this phone since the year of launch, and the crazy thing about it is that it really is good. The lifespan of the 3A obviously is no longer supported. It made its way all the way to Android 12 with, the underground scene for development. There are custom ROMs to put this on Android 13. It is a very, very solid phone, very capable, still good. It even has some of the features that we kind of miss. One of the big ones, the 3.5 millimeter headphone jack up on top. I mean, being able to plug in wired headphones, listen to your music without the reliance of wireless earbuds or headphones, it's just cool. I like to see devices that way. That's probably just me. That's probably my preference. But in general, with this device, it handles things even till today. I had my son use his phone for a while, and he likes to play his video games, and the phone held up to every game that he was playing, from Roblox to Five Nights at Freddy's to all these little weird games you find on a Play Store, Baldi and all that. And he plays all these games, and the phone performed just fine. It was great. He never came to me complaining that his game froze or something happened to his game. And it just goes to show, I mean, like, this phone can do it all. And at the time of release, it cost half the price of the Google Pixel 3. That was crazy. And it paved the way for a lot of the newer devices we have now, moving up throughout the A series, the 4A, the 4A 5G, and then the 5A bringing in a metal built option, the 6A having a camera that beat out flagship devices in a blind camera test. I mean, the A series really showed it was here to stay, and this was a foundation that started it all.